Because it's the next one. I mean, I guess I don't get the question. They're all big, I think.
Well, I mean, just kind of the build-off, you know, with the kind of you lost to them in the fashion that you did last year, and then kind of that video that came out earlier this summer and things like that.
I don't know anything about that video that came out, and we don't treat this like we do any other game. I mean, it's the build-up. That's all about the media and the fans, and we're preparing like this football game like we do any other game.
How tough is it to kind of curb the emotion of the players just with the way the game ended last year?
Last year's game has nothing to do with this Saturday. Nothing. That has nothing to do with it. It's different players, different teams, different time. And nothing that happened last year is going to impact this game this Saturday. And nothing. I mean, it's going to be one in between the lines on Saturday.
So being a defensive guy and what Will Muschamp's been able to do with Texas defense, respect for them, and just kind of talk about Texas defense with them.
Well, they're outstanding group. I mean, it's a very talented team. Run, you know, defensively, they run the ball. They run to the ball well. They play hard. I have a lot of respect for Will Muschamp. I think he's a tremendous defensive coach, and we'll have our work cut out for us. I mean, they've had 2 weeks to prepare. It'll be a big challenge for our offense.
When you watch the film on their two losses, do you see anything about the matchup between you guys and Texas that are weaknesses you can exploit, or are there things that you see where you might have the upper hand?
Well, no. I mean, there's some things that, one thing I know is they're good coaches over there, and they, you know, the things that they maybe struggled with, I promise you they get those areas fixed. And, it's just about executing our offense. It's about us. You know, you can't go, spend so much time going and trying to do this or do that somebody else did. You know, you got to execute what you do and be sound in what you do, and that's how you play good football. And I would say that the coaches over there would probably say the same thing. You know, you can't go too far out. I mean, obviously there's always some things you want to, maybe new wrinkles, those types of things you want to throw in, and that happens every week.
Gilbert said some growing pains for them a little bit at quarterback. Can you just talk a little bit about going up against maybe a younger, more inexperienced guy at quarterback and maybe what he does well?
I think he's an outstanding player. I think he has a tremendous big arm, makes good decisions. I think he's really good. You saw him. I don't think the environment's going to I hope it's loud and all that, so he has to deal with that. But he went in the national championship game on, pretty big stage and played really well. So, I mean, this guy's I think he's going to be a really good player for a lot of years to come for Texas. I mean, I think he's a really good football player.
What do you think about the run game?
I think they have some talented running backs. They haven't been able to run the ball consistently. There's a lot of reasons behind that. At times they've run it real well. At times they've done some really good things. And it's the same thing. That a lot of people are facing this time of year. It's a consistency issue.
Does that week they had off, coach, make you wonder a little bit more about what they're up to than if they had to come off a game Saturday here? Specifically offensively.
Yeah, I mean, you got to always expect that they're going to have something different to throw at you. I expect that every week.
Well, you said special teams was a big concern after the Kansas State game. Anything different or some things you're going to address this week, particularly in the coverage game?
No, we're going to get fixed. The things we had to need to get fixed, maybe a couple personnel changes here and there. That's about it.
Is it possible for a team to come out too fired up and lose focus?
Yeah.
Seen that happen? You've been around that in your days?
Yeah, well, once after the initial emotion's over, it's I mean, you're going to have adrenaline no matter what, but you got to play within yourself and so you execute. You can't be so, you know, running. It's not about running around and doing all that. It's about playing technique and fundamentals and executing your game. And you know, the whole fired up thing and all that. I hope our guys are fired up every week. I mean, you know. You have to play within yourself, and you got to channel your. The key to being a good football player is keeping your focus and where it needs to be focused on, and channeling your adrenaline and your excitement in the right direction. If you don't channel it in the right direction, it's not a good thing.
Everybody talks about Texas being on Ryan for the first time in over a decade or whatever, but I mean, can you stress to the people out there that this is still a very talented football team?
I would beg to say that there's no question in my mind that Texas is one of the top 25 football teams in the country. Where they're ranked, I don't care. You know, we have a lot of respect for their program, the talent over there, the coaching staff. You know, that's something they can't control, we can't control. I understand fully, and our team understands fully the challenge that's coming in here Saturday.
Coach, you had quite a few injuries in fall camp, but really not very many since the season started. How important has having most of your guys healthy been to where you are now?
Well, obviously you're a better football team when your guys are out there playing for you and you're not on the sidelines watching, so that's always a good thing.
You know, people have talked about Garrett Gilbert. This is a big stage for him. Conversely, you've got a quarterback who's the same age as Garrett. So how convinced are you that in his redshirt freshman year that he wouldn't get freaked out by this kind of big stage?
Well, I mean, in my opinion, they're all a big stage. You know, I mean, every time you walk out there, there's a responsibility to execute and do all those things. I don't see it as any bigger stage than what they faced last week or week before that. And like I said, it's about directing your focus, preparing the right way. And the more prepared you are, the better you're going to play.
Is it with Taylor, the redshirt freshman or young quarterback, you have to worry about the highs and lows and the peaks and the valleys? Has he been pretty consistent emotionally through it all?
Taylor? Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's a pretty calm, you know, cool and collected guy. But, you know, obviously there's times, you know, that when things go well for you, it's easier to handle. When you face adverse situations, it becomes a little more difficult. And you know, more experience you get, I think the calmer and more, you know, the more, you know, more confidence you have and the easier it is for you to handle any situation that comes down the road. But, you know, that's just part of the growing process with guys, you know, for all these young guys. I mean, everyone focuses on the quarterback. Really, that's the same. That's the truth across the board.
Lotus, Taylor's relative disinterest in talking to the media actually help him in a sense, because I'm sure he could be talking to 10 or 12 media outlets a week, but that's not remotely his interest. Do you think that assists him? And although you never restrict players from talking to media, are you happy that he has that kind of focus?
I don't know if it's that's his focus or he just doesn't like to talk. I mean, he... I mean, Taylor doesn't say much. He's a quiet guy. Period. He's quiet around us. He's, you know, that's just who he is. And you know, whatever works for a guy. You know, like you don't want to make him do anything he doesn't feel comfortable doing. I think that, you know, the more he grows into the situation he's in, I think he'll open up and be more inclined to talk to the media more. You know, it just, you know, I think all those things happen in time.
Would you prefer that he was more of the face of the program, or are you comfortable with where he is?
I don't believe in anybody being the face of the program, me included. I think it's a team game. It's a, you know. But I also understand that, you know, he's getting a lot of attention, and I understand that's part of it too.
You'll probably get this question basically every week the rest of the way, with it being the last year in the Big 12. But when you're facing Texas for potentially the last time in a long time, is there a different feel to it?
No.
Especially with how good each program has been for so long?
No, not really. Not for me. That's more a question for other people. I don't know.
Can you talk about the significance of that, just in the grand scheme of things, with the two programs' histories?
I don't know really what you want me to say. I mean, it is what it is. I mean, it's the last game for a while, and you know,